স্যার, উই নো ইউ আর দি ফাউন্ডার অ্যান্ড প্রেসিডেন্ট অফ দি মানুষ মানুষের জন্য ফাউন্ডেশন। ইউ ডিড ইট ফ্রম দি সোশ্যাল রেসপন্সিবিলিটিস অ্যান্ড ইট পারফর্মস এ লট অফ হিউম্যানিটেরিয়ান অ্যাক্টিভিটিস। কনসিডারিং দি কারেন্ট সোশিও ইকোনমিক কন্ডিশন অফ আওয়ার কান্ট্রি, হোয়াট সোশ্যাল অন্টারপ্রেনারশিপ আইডিয়াস ইউথ ক্যান অ্যাডপ্ট?
So big question. Okay. If the first point is that if this foundation, nonprofit foundation, is in America, I had to face it differently. But for Bangladesh, I had to do it a little bit differently. How? I always thought that in our country we have a lot of talented people, but they are mostly, even wasted. Like, say, many people are going to Middle East for labor work. I have seen it from my own neighborhood in my village. That one guy was playing very good football, but he doesn't have the opportunity for going further. So there is nothing. They don't know even how to do that. So many different talented people are there in Bangladesh, but the opportunity is not there. So when I come across in different countries and got experience and got kind of little bit established, not like the big people or rich people, but like some kind of, say, I can take at least some food and I can survive. That is the ultimate goal of my life. I don't know many others, but for myself, I am very simple to take only some foods. Just very little moderate life is fine for me. But I see that many people who even don't have these two meals in a day, because I'm also a struggler from very beginning of my life. Even one day, not one day, many days I have to beg to others' yard for some rice, for a blanket. So I feel that not only me, many others in the line are very talented. They don't have opportunity. So the Manush Manusha Janna Foundation is mainly focusing the education, mainly. In our whole budget, about 80 to 90% are allocated for education. So why so? Not like other charities, many other charities. Charities have to be in many different fields. I cannot criticize or do something, because everyone may be unique, of course, because of the needs they see. So for us, I thought that the talented students are not taken up. They don't have the way to tell their own thoughts. So if I established a startup in Bangladesh, it could be really difficult for me to get funding to have this initiative, and also how many fields I can do, I can invest. It is impossible. That is why I thought that let me bring all together by public charity, help people through education, and tell them every day or in some communication methods that what they have in reality. Like, for example, we get a lot of applications from our students across whole Bangladesh, like all public universities or the colleges. They always say about that their life goal is to be mainly 99% cases, to be a BCS candidate finally. They like to be a BCS cadre. How many BCS cadre a country can hold? But no one is interested in taking new challenge. BCS is what? In the beginning, they do a lot of study, get establishment, and many people, they do not use their brain because there is no scope. But there are a lot of opportunities in a private line. They don't have the courage, the students, how to take the challenge into the front. So our charity is formed in a way that even it is registered that way, that we get education for the students, train them, in a way that they know about the life value, they think about their own thoughts, take their concepts, we help a little bit, but they have to think about their life and establish for the society needs. So right now, still, we are not pushing too much to get out from BCS side because we don't have too much graduate yet, a little bit. But by now, already few entrepreneurs are created who were sponsored before by us. And we also regularly consult or give feedback in inbox or somewhere or by phone that what they are doing is right or wrong. So the first thing is that they have to be honest. So whenever you are honest, you face a more difficulty because different difficulties in the society. But still, being honest for a long time is just a process so that you can better serve the society. So that's why we came across the education first, so that they understand the value of what they have. Of course, everything is challenging in everywhere, even here. We don't have challenge, it is not the case. The challenges are very different. Of course, in Bangladesh, very different challenge and very critical even. But still, we tell them that we are not only serving the university engineering student. We are everywhere. You take our opportunity, think your thing. If you have difficulty, you let us know. But in thinking process, what do you like to do, say, for a business? We can help. So that way, we recently did some, because our students are now growing. So during the pandemic is an opportunity. People may get even mad. So we take an opportunity through rehabilitation process that so that they do not stop. But they also take initiative with a small, very small fund. But they can, what they can do? We can see that more than 98% cases, everyone is very successful that with very small fund, like 3 to 5, 6 thousand taka only, which is a meal only in the US or Europe, but they can survive better and also having much extra income or even the main income of the family. So that way they got successful. Then now we are thinking about families beyond these students, about 1,000 families. So that way, whenever they learn about the structure of the society, what they need, what he was grown up with, and also what he's facing through left and right in the neighborhood or in everywhere, he gets through the knowledge, behavior, communication skill. That way they are established. So I don't have the fund in order to employ them because they need money, because they are all are underprivileged, right? But if I give this release of their own life, they can now put in their head free to think about what the life goal is. Then now, because they can now see that other problems through our project, like this family I can stand by. I can lead this family's thing through our Manush Manushodhan Foundation. They are free to propose us. That way, they are actually implementing their knowledge they are gathering from the class. That way, just one example, say, Jewel Mamun. We are not telling about the results now, but entrepreneurship now. Jewel Mamun is one of the example. He is doing some mango business and agricultural products hunt or something, agro hunt, he said. So within 2-3 years, he became very successful. He's just distributing the mangoes in everywhere. He's our student one day. He's from Russia University. One day he was in very, very big crisis that he even earned money through rickshaw biking. But we get him, give enough consultation, discussion, everything. He is confident and he himself has to go through in thought that how he become independent. The way we give him knowledge, then he today, I can say that his business within 2-3 years is very big now, because his whole family is independent now. They are already even donating to other people now. They are helping others. Business is there, and the business is connecting the farmers to market. Farmers are in critical condition that they cannot supply the mango in the right right price. But now these people directly are buying from there and going to the field already. But their graduate, remember it, he and his brother Alamgir. But they are going to directly that mango garden. They are helping, talking, communication skill is there to the low level and taking it into the market and also talking with the experts. So they are actually converting their concept from the low level to high level everywhere. They are good today. So it's only one example. Another example, say our project manager, Fahim Ahmed, he was communicating with a lot of projects people, director, and also thinking about how to get its success. And also in future, how we can stream people in that line. So we are having a lot of different lines now, thinking that because we cover many different universities, even the doctor, how we put this knowledge that they become not only their own family members, but they can also think about the society. Whenever you are thinking about the society, then of course your entrepreneurship will bring up in your mind. You are motivated because you can see the gap. So if it is a startup in Bangladesh, with my pocket money, I could not do that job. So that is why I'm in a little bit difficulty in sometime that why we call it charity. It is a non-profit. In America, we have the non-profit. Non-profit is not doing this kind of job. But we are doing this job because of the situation that I don't have my pocket money. I don't have grant from any government. But I have to utilize this underprivileged students because even they can be, you know, they can be fall into, you know, without any education, they can go home back because of the crisis, the financial crisis. So we see a lot of examples that many students, they start their class after some crisis because father or mother is sick, they are struggling, and one day they are even in crisis. You can see it in even SSC, ACC graduates number. They are declining and declining because people are not interested. They don't have to do that. So however, your knowledge is not in the right pool, you have less motivation in order to proceed. So that is why I think that it is pretty important to put the knowledge of these people in entrepreneurship, because it is very important to put our young people into this new motivation, because they, so you can say that, okay, it is zero now. I would not say zero it now, because it is not visible. I have to put it zero. I see new generation right now because of the smart digital arena. Currently, I can see now some young people are coming up, but they are facing a lot of difficulties. For example, OxyZ is one of them. If someone is more motivated with money and the process, they could invest the money, but there is no confidence. So in order to give the confidence, the government have to have some institute, like the machine tools company is one of them, they control, right? So that way, like some national lab are there. So one thing I have to tell, in the whole world, there is no country that can be called developed unless they have their own manufacturing product. Just take every country. America, of course, you know. China, today, they are Communist Party controlled, right? But still, they have to come across this market. They are coming through society, through manufacturing products. Out of 100, 80 products are from China, or more than that. Because they do everything, is low labor cost, they can make it. And manufacturing business is there. US and other developed countries are declining only because China was increasing, right? Their economy was increasing because of the manufacturing product. Today, they're the biggest economy in the world, maybe. And manufacturing is one of them that they're bringing up like this. So any country you have to have in manufacturing, very established. Another example, for example, PPE. I wrote it a little bit. PPE gown. In Bangladesh, we had this technology already before us, but it was not out of factory. It was the link between factory and the South Korea, maybe. So EPZ was making the PPE gown for their own country and the foreign currency. But the Bangladesh government and no other people knew about the gown that could be made in Bangladesh. So we don't have even the garments company to make the PPE gown. That's why in the beginning, we see a lot of raincoat. And it was just shading everywhere, right? A lot of raincoats. But we repeatedly said about that gown is very important for health professionals. So because we know that the process a little bit, so it is again the life safety, right? But still, we went through the level approval, level one, level two, level three. We faced difficulties. But it's one of the examples that currently our garments company are able to make our own gown. In the beginning, the government, as far as I know, they brought in some PPE gowns from China and also UK as per the quality. But now they don't have to buy it. Because this small initiative, even by the non-profit like Manush Manush Junno and Pay It Forward Bangladesh, we take a little bit in approval process, the government helped. That's why within a very few months, a few weeks to months, the whole market is now full of these PPE gowns, and now government is making even money with foreign currency by supplying the PPE gowns. So because they helped us, the private line like us, the technology is up there. And now Dhaka and Chittagong, the garments factory in Shabar or Narayanganj, everywhere the companies now able to do, they don't have to do too much thing, new machine. They have to only retrofit the machines. So manufacturing is there. Because we have the company manufacturing, now we are making the money. Like that, any other garments manufacturing, without having those initiative, Bangladesh should not have the foreign currency, right? So if you have the manufacturing, you have money. That is the final question. Final answer. That you have manufacturing set up, you can just go up and up. Another example is India, like say Rolls Royce and other companies are there alongside IIT and other companies. So however, the government understood that problem, then IIT is now involved. Those companies, they give access to those foreign companies because they don't have their own expertise. They give the opportunity, those companies settle down. Now I see that they invested a lot of money over there in their country. So government have to take the initiative in the beginning in order to play the role for the young generations so that others can see that their knowledge can be utilized to understand the know-how. Once this is developed like that, independent, then people don't have to rely too much in the other countries. So like that, Oxygen would come in and other many products. We have ability, but we are not there in taking that initiative. So that is one of the big thing our private sector have to think about, and the government has to take a little bit, at least help. Their own know-how, say like BCS people, many engineering people are there, but not many people know-how thing for getting approval. So the government have to put the right people to know about this product and how to get approval this thing. If they don't know it, then this is a big fault because we are giving money, people's money in their pocket, but they do not do our own job for the society. So it's a big gap. Yeah, thank you. Sorry for this long, long, long answer.
No problem, sir. Appreciate your kind efforts. And many of us definitely will be motivated from your work, sir. I would like to request our audience to write down your question in comment box, because it's a big opportunity to get our questions answered live. So raise your question, guys. Now, I have the last question for you, sir. Many startups have been initiated by... Sir, many startups have been initiated by young entrepreneurs, even B researcher BD. Also initiated by a young professor, you know. So if you had one piece of advice to a new young entrepreneur just starting out, what would it be?
I think they have to know their own job. This is the first thing. They have to explore themselves. It is very important for them to know what they are doing. It is not like that, again, I am saying, just like a bucket of water, whatever the quality is, and people are thirsty, I am giving, throwing it to them, people. This is what in Bangladesh is most cases happening. Many people are there. So some people are just even making some, you know, lemon water or something like this in the front, in the road. So people are thirsty because of the hot environment. And then they say that, okay, anything can be sold. No system is there. So these right people need to be honest what they are serving to, because it is their own family, own environment. This is first thing. Being honest, to be honest, it does not take money. It is just mentality that I serve this thing, I'm satisfied. This is one thing. To add on this thing, they have to know how to get good water. Again, I'm taking the example of water. I know that people are thirsty. People can take even very, like, the river water from Buriganga. But I don't give it because I know that I have to serve it better. Not for attracting people. It is to let them know that you are taking this water because this is the quality. That means you have the quality list. You write down because you know how. And you let people know that this is a good thing for your survival. Today, we can see a lot of kidney patients, a lot of cancer patients. And many people are from even village side. It is very unbelievable. Why? Because they did not know what they are using, fertilizer, chemical. They were working on fertilizer. Even I did as well in Bangladesh. So they are working in farming, right? They are using fertilizer. And many fertilizers are very effective for preventing from insects, diseases, right? But right. These people do not know what is a chemical. First thing is that they do not put mask. If a quality people is there, they should tell that this is your life, this is your family safety. Do this job this way, one thing. Second thing is that they are mixing the chemical into the land, right? If these people say that this is a chemical, let us go with compost, the fertilizer. Let us make it. We have a lot of cows. We have a lot of goats. We can make them because a lot of things are here and there. We can make them. We are entrepreneur. Yes, of course, entrepreneur need to know these things. You don't have to be scientist. It is that some information is there. They don't have to even from science background. They know about these things are needed to make this compost. They make it in one place, and then people let them people or some expertise is there to let them know that these are the thing of the quality because those are tested. If they initiated this compost fertilizer for the farmers, then not many people could be in this dangerous today. This very dangerous thing that kidney, lung disease, cancer, many things are happening in almost every family has sick people now, as per I know. So why? Because we do not know how to live a life. We know that it is a life. We are taking food. We are thirsty. Everything is fine. So what is the knowledge? What knowledge you are using? You have a lot of universities. You have a lot of medicals. A lot of things. Medical is full of sick people, patients, and university is full of people with 4x4 GPA, with 5x5 in SSC and SSC. But we do not know actually what we are doing in the practical life, right?
That's it.
So we first question is that what people are thinking, I don't need to know. If I am an entrepreneur, I just need to know that this is my product. This has this system out, and these are the list of my product about the thing, service. Then I give it to these people. Only 5 people is good enough in the beginning. But at least so a product is not a product. A product is a message.
Of course, sir. Of course.
See, everything is like this, that what I do, my younger will follow me. If I do wrong thing, he or she is also doing the right bad thing, right? So from the family or everywhere, we have to think that way, that what I am doing, it is just a kind of role model thing. So that way, if they do, otherwise, we are just bringing low hanging fruits and taking it. So people do not like to ride on the tree. They don't know the pain of this tree. Riding on the tree. They only just climb and other things they don't know. Just say that, okay, I cannot take this fruit. Okay, give some, throwing some stone, put it back. So stone is there and you're putting back, it's getting down. It is not scientific way. You can always make yourself okay, but it is not the right way. You have to know the system. You have to know about the whole thing. You put money over there. So I think that it is very available as the economy in Bangladesh is rising, but it's not sustainable to me. You have a lot of money, but unless you know your own money is not circulating, it would not sustain for a long time. So there is a place, money is getting always bigger when you put money in some places. Money has to be circulated. Then economy will be stronger and people will be with knowledge, better knowledge. And honest knowledge, for the honest knowledge, you have to be in the system. In our country, example I'm giving, I say, for example, I face one patient at my home. I go to hospital, then the hospital is not taking my patient. Why? Because I don't have the seat. So I see that I already know 5 seats are there, because why they are not taking my seat, my patient there. Then someone is calling me saying that, hey, Chandra, can you call this person? Then he can call this top person. Then you'll get a seat. What does it mean? Mean that they have seat, they do not give you. You are deprived unless you have the network of reference. So that means that if you have reference like this from the top people, you are judged. It cannot be the way. There is a system. System is that you take a patient. If you have the ability with all system right, you have to be there. In our country, very unfortunate is that we always have to go with some reference always. So that way it cannot be sustainable. As far as you are honest, you can deliver this message at least from by you, then by your neighbor, by your home, neighbor, everything. Everything has to go right away. And the government and the other offices have to appreciate this thing. It's not only a single BCS. It has to be in many sides.
That's great, sir. We have all the resources, but we have to utilize it in a systematic way. Right,
of
sir?
Course. Systematic way is again, system is system. System is not like this in a way that I know this person, please take it. Not like this. You know the system, I don't know. I don't bother about it. I know I need to have his document. It is systematic. It's not that I know Sabir, I know Umar, I know Naim, not like this. He's a very good person. No. Today is good person. Tomorrow he cannot be a good person, maybe. So system is system, that your document is there. You have to prove it. So that's why if you give some, release, say for example, I'm taking an example from Manush Manushu Jana Foundation when dealing from charity side. People think that charity is charity, giving, take money and give it. Why they need to maintain that much? See, all of us are not a single person until this March 2021 or April. We always do everything free. Currently, only one manager is employed a little bit money, but everything is free. All people across the Bangladesh we are suffering is free. Still, we are dealing in a way that a single person is not by reference or something that they can escape our system. Even if he or she is my own brother or sister, still the same thing. I can give the example, my sister-in-law, during the PPE ground crisis, she's a doctor. During that time, because she has to serve people, she is eager to help people. But because she is in private and we set a rule that we can only provide the PPE gown to public people, public medical, it has to go through public medical, but we do not go for private medical doctors to serve. She is my sister-in-law, but still I would not give her. It is the law. So not only me, in our whole team in MMJ and Pay It Forward, we had a lot of people related to doctor, right? Directly, sister or the sister-in-law in Bangladesh. But there is no single report that throw this way, we get it. Even our secretary's sister is also a doctor from public institution. Still, she was not given upfront. She was given at the time when their hospital was in the list in the serial. So we know that it is a life safety. We could bring it and give it away, right away. By that time. But our secretary bought one PPE gown for his sister from another company with the approved gown. Because our system is taking a time because we are covering whole country. So immediately he bought it from other company, but he could not take it from MM's side for his sister. This is the system. Whenever we set a system, it has to be there. There is no brother sister, there is no. So this is still a charity, but still we follow system. So without system, without professionalism, you cannot be a good success. So whenever you are making the path from poor country to developing to develop and something like this, you have to go across and you have to establish those things very strongly.
That's right, sir. No nepotism should be a go. Now we're going to take some questions from our audience, if you permit me, sir.
Yep, please. Yeah, go ahead.
One of our audience, named Rasay Harun, asked a question to you, sir. Should a researcher have an entrepreneur mind from the beginning of the research work?
I think this is a good question. Because I was a researcher, so I think it does not come across from the very first day. You have to put yourself not a researcher, I think that you have to more involved in engineering background or some kind of, say, if you are a social researcher, still you have to say a social need. So how do I take it an example? For example, I do some mango business again. So mango business. So I'm in a company and I have to do some research from, I'm agricultural graduate. So I know I'm a researcher, I'm working for this. So I have to know about detail about the product and everything. First, I know about the whole market, right? Because my company is giving the opportunity that your research is being, your research, what research? This product, how it will serve people, how people will take it, customer, and how long it can survive during the hot time or cold time or the whole year. Something like this you are researching, right? An insect or something like this. Insect disease through this fruit, because it is a fruit you are taking in health. So that way, for a mango, you are taking that research, for example. So from the first day, you cannot think about the entrepreneurship. From the first day, you have to be more involved in the thought that you are serving the society and see that whether your mango is good to have sustainability. Once you know that you are facing a lot of problems, that is not a good thing, you are learning a lot, then whenever you are having this problem solved, then later you are actually making more mangoes, right? Because you see that mango, particular mango, cannot really serve, or people, not all people like it. So then you are thinking about new gene, about a new mango. That way you are actually producing something. And one day you are thinking that you have enough experience. Suddenly your brain is triggering out that, okay, let me do something as entrepreneurship, because I do a lot of research, but looks like those mangoes are not going to people. So we did a lot of things here, but those are not in the market. Why? Some other formalin added mangoes are there. Why mine one is better? Because I already worked for this mango to serve it for at least 6 months during different environment. But still, why it is not working? So you can say that, of course, some businessman is taking like this. That's why you cannot pull it, right? Okay. Take this challenge as a new entrepreneur, saying that business is held by some big people, by formalin, but let me do this job for my side. I do the, like Jewel Mamun. They are doing some a little bit research, though they are not from that background, economy background and other things. But still, they are thinking that how to protect the market. That people taking taking from formalin, let me serve very slowly. So you have to get into, I mean, like this pen, you see that the whole thing is very smooth and straight, but here it is like a taper, right? So like every pin, every wire, if you like to penetrate it, it has to be very like a needle. So you have to penetrate and go market. So you have to put your concept for the people that they don't know everything, right? Because they even are not literate. So how do you put your energy behind them? You have to have your passion that this is my business. I take today this opportunity because I can at least survive myself with two meals. But I was born up, sorry, I was born and brought up or grown up for making something better for the society. I see that my neighbor is not having good mangoes. My family is not getting good mangoes. I am making as a mango researcher, I am doing good job at R&D, but my family is getting formalin added mango. Then what is my research? I'm doing one thing and my home is suffering from others by the same product. That's why you have to think that, okay, this is the gap that somebody has to be there. And if I leave this current job only to survive two meals or something like this, but I have to take this because I have now knowledge. Even I can create my R&D, new R&D. Then because I know that how the gene works, I can create new mangoes later in my R&D. But let me at least implement what of the concept I received, put it in the market. See a little bit, see at least your neighbor, like a tailoring machine, right? People just sewing in the beginning and give it to the friend and this thing and the neighbor and this thing, only 5 taka. Maybe from the market, it is maybe 50 taka, but 5 taka, give it, just only my labor work. I don't have to have your profit, just give it. So that way they are convinced that, Shohagi is making very good shirt. Let me take it from her because it's only 5 taka, 50 taka. She's convinced. Later second day, the relationship is there, better. And 20, 30, and I keep it 40 maximum, not 50. Whenever it is 40, then she or the neighbor is consistently taking my product. Why? Because product is good. I don't have a good big chain that the profit is being lost in part. But I'm making better job. So now my concept is there because I already developed my neighbor. I give it to my relative, to other land, saying that please do this job in your field. I can guide you. That way you're actually broadening up with a new concept, but still you are serving better because of the know-how and honesty. So know-how and honesty is very important in order to better serve. I always feel that it is very important to be a good entrepreneur with very good, honest mind. And one big thing I have to also tell here is that many young entrepreneurs are now coming up. Problem is that we are more dominated with religion. So that is for true. For myself also, religion is also important for our life. But the problem is that we do not cultivate our own religion into our daily business. We do it in the prayer room only. That's all. We go to different good religious institutions to pray, then come here in the home. We do not follow honesty, but our income is through a dishonest business. So this is not the religion. I always feel that in every work you do, it has to be a religion. Your work itself is a religion. You follow your religion. Religion is a principle of your life. Whenever you set it, you may fail, but one product, two product, no, you have the confidence, you have a lot of background. put that energy there. You fail today, that fail can bring you into another second one in the next day. Nobody, I mean, a baby within 1 year get a lot of, you know, accidents, but they become greater. So in Bangla, we can say it husot. We get it, then we walk. We do not walk in the first day, right? So that way, we have to think that we are not always being successful. We have to go through in the path, but one day it will come. Do not take another way that today I have to take this money because of this problem. My daughter or my father is sick. I have to take this thing because of this thing. No, you are actually taking the religion in the prayer room and not the other place, and your father or daughter are being created with the dishonest thing. So this is not the religion. So because it's the professionalism, and our talk is more on now professionalism, but where we fail, that is what I'm saying, is that many entrepreneurs are there, but whenever there's a business, people think that this guy is business people. This guy is business, right? He's a politics. This guy is business. Don't talk about business. Why? Because people do not trust the business people. But in America, they also know the business. We know that Amazon people, Jeff Bezos is also a business person. Some other people are also. We know that, but still it is very systematic. So without business, you cannot even stand. In our country, in Bangladesh, more than 10 lakhs are small, medium companies, like shop and other things, but you have to survive with the business. Without business, not my family, maybe other family, maybe in business. So family business has to be there, but it has to be honest. You are serving better at the end of the day. You have to answer yourself that you serve today everything cleanly. That is your religion. Once you can make sure that you are in a way that the next day you serve better, because you find gap in the first day, second day you do the better, because you have to only survive through this religion.
Amazing answer, sir. Researchers always get, in the end, researchers always get extra facilities in their entrepreneurship journey, actually. I hope Harun Bhaiya got the answer. As our time's already up, you know, we need to finish it now. Thank you, sir, for your valuable time. We learned a lot of things, and definitely our audience has been benefited. I would like to also thank our audience for your participation. To get updates on our activities, follow our page, join our group, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are happy to inform you that we are now a family of more than 29,000 members, including group, page, and channel within 1 year already. Stay with Goveshok Hote Chai, the researcher BD platform, and invite your research enthusiast friends to our platform. Thank you for being with us. Wish you all success and good health. Stay home, stay safe. Goodbye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Again, thank you.